Welcome, all friends of the Dhamma. Come back home, the knower. Today, I will let you do meditation from the mind. Then the mind wake up with mindfulness and got the power of meditation, okay? The knower, normally when you watch, you not watch mindfully. You look with desire, with pleasant feeling, unpleasant feeling. The knower gone, the mind or the knower gone through the five channel. Okay, eye, ear, nose, tongue, and body contact. When you contact something you like, your mind lost. The knower gone. Where the knower? Okay? First, you see the mind. Where the knower? When the traffic jam and you go to the airport. Traffic jam. Where the knower, you know? The knower lost to the airport because you have worried about missing the flight. You have a lot of thought. You are here on the road, but the knower just think about the airport, okay? So now, can you see the mind with thought first? Because you must be able to see the mind with thought, then you can see the knower. But when you arrive at the airport, no thought, no worry, because you arrive at the airport, okay? Or you check in already. And no worry anymore. Can you see the mind, no thought? Or in other words, can you see the calmness of mind? Calmness from thought. Okay? When you got calmness, you know the present moment, what you are doing. But you not have calmness. You lost in thought. You just worry about the flight and you don't know. You're not knowing what you are doing. You're just thinking about missing the flight, sitting, don't know, okay? Movement, don't know, breathing, don't know, the stomach movement, don't know, or whatever you are doing, you don't know. But when you check in already, okay, now you know. You don't worry, you know the present moment. Drink coffee, okay? Or just prepare yourself, or go to the customer, you know with the calmness. When you got the calmness, you got knowing in the calmness, knowing the present moment, okay? Can you see first? You see thought, but you never train to see thought and no thought. Nobody can have thought the whole day without stop. You think without stop or not? No. You think and you have no thought in between and think and no thought. Okay? So can you see no thought when you check in already? You don't worry about the flight and you just enjoy yourself now. You're sitting relaxed, waiting for departure time. Okay? And now you got your mind come back. And how you know you got your mind come back? No worry. And when you no worry, your mind not go out. Your mind only know you sit this way, you sit this way, you move this way, you relax. Okay? This is because you got calmness. You got knower. Knower will come with calmness. But knower will lost with thought. Okay? Even if you come to a meditation retreat, you have something in your mind worry about your family. You say, rising, you know, falling, you know, you chanting, knowing, or you breathing in, you watch, breathing in, breathing out. But you lost every every minute loss, or maybe every 10-15 second loss, because your mind got something we call the formation of mind. Okay, we call the formation of mind. So that's why, because when you got calmness, you know, you can know yourself the present moment. Okay, knowing the calmness more and more, you will got seeing yourself. Knowing in the calmness, and that means knowing not enough. Okay, but first knowing in the calmness, more knowing in the calmness, you got seeing yourself. Okay, when you got seeing yourself, you got fully wake up. Okay, fully conscious. Okay, knowing, seeing. So today I will let you train yourself to see your mind. Your mind as thought you see, but when you relax, no thought. Can you see your mind no thought? Okay. And very important, when you make decision, before you have to think first. Think about how to invest the money, but thinking only not help you to make decision. But when you just have no thought in between, think to do this good or not, then you have no thought or stop thinking. When you have no thought or stop thinking, the knower wake up with intuitive awareness or wisdom. Okay, I will do it. Or I will not do it. Okay. So when you got thought, you can observe yourself or not. Before you make decision, you stop thinking, maybe 2-3 seconds. Okay, I do it. Can you observe when you have something to think, but before you make decision, the moment you make decision, you stop thinking. 2-3 seconds, and then you got seeing the future of business, seeing what will happen if you do it, then you make decision. I take it, I do it, I not take it, I not do it. That's right. Because you know, when I start thinking about the formula, okay, but how he know the formula EMC². He just drink, take coffee. Oh, this is solution, EMC². Okay? So the same, when you have a lot of thinking, you worry, you involve. But when you have no thought, how to got no thought, how to get no thought, just drink coffee. Then intuition or intuitive awareness wake up. This is by nature, but if you know this step, knowledge, wisdom come from thought and no thought, thought, no thought. So you just observe yourself. If you only thinking about those, about this, you cannot make decision. But immediately you can calm down your mind. Okay, I take it. Okay, I do it. Okay, so this is meditation in your workplace, in daily life. So, okay, don't worry too much. You worry, you thinking too much, you cannot get solution. Okay, but you need to have your thought carefully, careful thinking, but careful thinking, and in between with awareness. Awareness come back. No thought there. No thought that then you get nowhere, wake up with intuition. Okay? So then the in daily life, how to solve all the problem. Everything got problem. You just think and how to get no thought. Thinking about the problem and let go. Let go, how to let go. If you cannot let go, you can drink coffee. Then you change your mind, come to coffee. Then your mind let go. Okay? When your mind let go, you got something we call intuitive awareness, wake up. Okay? Also, when you play sport, okay? When you play sport, when you hitting, okay? And the moment you hitting really powerful with power, that moment, stop thinking, okay? The moment you hit the ball with power, your mind become knower, without thought, with full awareness, okay? Full awareness, and then your mind got power to hit, okay? You know, Thai boxing, now, if you practice Thai boxing, the moment you escape, you think about your family or not when you escape? No! You're not thinking anything. Can you see no thought when you escape? If you can see no thought, it become meditation. Then you just hit with power of mind. Okay? Okay? So, now you have meditation in daily life, but you don't know. When you walk on the street, the car nearly hit you. You think about your job or not? No, you just escape. And that, not only the body escape, your mind come back. When you escape the accident, your mind come back. Come back to the knower. Okay? And with the power from the mind to keep your body away from the accident. Okay? So, at that moment, you got very good mindfulness when you be careful, escape, and your mind, you don't have to try to stop thinking. It stop. Stop and wake up and help you, protect you, okay? Bring you from out from accident. That's right? Okay. So, if you can see your mind in daily life, seeing thought more or less, and by nature, your mind rest by itself. Can you see your mind rest by itself? No thought. And rest maybe for a few seconds. Have some thought again. Don't worry. Your mind become thought. You see it. When you see it, your mind come to rest. Can you see your mind come to rest? No thought. And you can see your mind no thought. Emptiness. Okay? So now, we just, if somebody still cannot catch what I say, you got no thought when you go to the dentist. And the dentist put something in your mouth, cleaning. You think about family, or you stop thinking and watch? You stop thinking and watch. Can you see when the dentist clean your teeth? Your mind not go anywhere. Just watch here. This is meditation. Okay? This is meditation. The right meditation because you watch yourself. Okay? Okay? And when the dentist say, this one need to take out, got some problem. You think about anything? No! You just watch and see, aware, mindful, and calm, and still, quiet, knowing, seeing. Maybe take 15 minutes. Still, quiet, and watch, and see, and aware. This is by nature. You come back to the knower by nature, but you don't know. So, how you watch the mind from the knower? Where you wash your tooth? Take it out. Where? When you wash your tooth, where your mind? no thought, quiet, still, calm, aware, mindful, knowing, seeing clearly without thought. Now can you mindful, still, quiet, seeing yourself sitting, breathing, movement, watch, seeing, knowing, aware, mindful, without thought? Can you see it? You not only see the mind, but you can see the quality of mind. More mindfulness or more awareness when you watch your tooth. More mindfulness if it takes you 15, half an hour to take off. You got more and more mindfulness, more and more awareness because you have to be careful, careful, okay? So we call this is object of knowing. When the dentist cleansing or take your tooth out, your tooth is the object. But when you wash, can you see the one who wash? The one who wash we call the knower. Phu lu in Thai language. Phu lu. Phu lu or the knower. Okay. So in the forest tradition, I have been practiced in the forest tradition when I was about 70 years old. Then the master said, okay, go and find the knower. I try to find the knower more than 20 years, I don't know. But when I go to the dentist, what? Oh, knower come, you know? Oh, the knower, when I wash my breathing, I focus too much. The knower go to the object, attach, and try to force the breathing soft and soft and subtle, subtle, subtle. You lose your knower, okay? Then you can force your mind maybe a few minutes. After 5 minutes, I think maximum 5 minutes to force your mind still. After 5 minutes, become disturbed. But if your mind got thing to know, got thing to see, okay? Got thing to know, got thing to see. Then your mind become calm, no thought by itself. And you can see that the mind got thing to know, the mind got thing to see. When you got calmness, the mind become knowing, seeing, seeing, knowing, seeing, seeing, knowing in the mind. That's right. Okay. Now, as in the for less tradition, okay, always those practitioners, especially monks, they just talk about the knower, the knower, the knower. Before I was young, I don't know, but now I know. I know when I got to the dentist, I know, oh, this is the knower. And then I just see when I cross the street and sometimes nearly fallen, my mind immediately stop thinking and help the body. Nah, not fall down. This is the knower. Okay? And my follower, she is a 30 years old woman. She got accident completely, the car fall down. And she said, Master, you teach me the knower. The knower help me. The knower tell me, just keep this way, okay? Then the car fall down, but she said, okay? The knower tell her, just protect yourself, okay? Then no problem, no injury, okay? Okay, so sometimes I got my experience, but before I don't know the knower, okay? I sit in the car. A car got nearly accident, nearly fallen down. Before I was a layman, okay? I don't know this is the knower. Then the car nearly falling down. Immediately, I stop thinking and watch. I go into the meditation by nature. And with this meditation, it looked like why it fall down very softly, softly. Okay? no damage. Then after that, not only me, there are 5-6 people in the van. Then we come out to help to take the van up and then go further. Go further. So this is we call the knower, okay? The knower or Buddha, okay? Or body mind. Body mind, this is really important. If your body mind, the knower, disturb, you work hard, but not work smart, you bring your work at home. Your knower stay at home, but still thinking about your job, because you bring your work at home, then you know your knower, okay, become disturbed. Then you have very seriousness on your face, okay, because you even stay at home, you still bring your work at home, and what you got? Your children see your face, and your children come to you. You not speak nice. Your children got problem. Okay, so you got your job at home. You lose warm in your family. Okay, you lose warm in your family. Okay, but if you work, when you come back home, just left. Okay. You never know the present moment with family, okay, with children. Then you got a warm family, and your kid will have no problem. But now you bring your disturbed mind back home. You make your children short meditation, okay? Now many kids, even in Thailand, have problem. No good meditation, children. Why? Because the economic, everything depressed, and the parent got many disturbed mind a lot. Come back home, no warm family. All children become lost with parents, okay? Okay, and fear, and then your children need to go out because in the family not warm. They need to go and go with friend. If they got good friend, no problem. If they got not good friend, maybe drug, then drug addict, okay? So your mind, there are two kinds of power. People always practice meditation for the power of mind. Power of mind, jhana, or power of mind to see something that I cannot see. Okay? This is not good power. Okay? Because this power of mind, when you practice meditation, you got this power of mind. But we call this power of mind is psychic power. It's not good for practice vipassana or insight or for enlightenment. But there is the other power. You calm down the mind, still the mind, and with the knower. Okay? And in the knower with mindfulness, with awareness. And with mindfulness and awareness, your knower clean and clear and pure. And from the pure mind, you don't have to focus anything to develop psychic power, but your knower will have wholesome power. Because your mind clean and clear, clear and clean, when you come back home, this clean power will bring up your children, will bring up your family, will bring up your business, will bring up whatever, become better, okay? So this we call in Thai language bunyalit, wholesome power. Okay? The other thing is psychic power, italit. Italit not good, okay? But bunyalit, wholesome power is good. Okay? You with this mind, good mind, clear mind, clean mind, you go anywhere, you got good people come to you, got thing come, good thing come to your life. I traveling in European country, I never lost. I get people to help me. Okay? So now, we call to purify your mind good, clean and clear. Don't expect your mind to be able to do that, to do this with psychic power. Not, that is not the way. Okay? Okay. So now, I just bring you back to the Nova. Okay? First lesson. Okay? Just chewing. When you're chewing, your eye cannot look. But your mind can watch and know. Can you watch in your mouth? Watch from the mind. But watch, you must develop knowing, seeing together. Watch and knowing, and knowing and seeing how you chewing, how you eating. This is object. I sit on the seat. This is the object. Object is on my seat. So or heart is on my seat. It's object of knowing. But this we call feeling. But I can know in my mind knowing. My mind don't have to come to feeling. Feeling is feeling. Knowing is knowing. Feeling is on your seat. But knowing is in your mind. Can you? Can you know in your mind how soft or hard the cushion is? Can you know in your mind? Yeah. Can you know in your mind how soft or hard? And can you see what you sitting over? Can you see? Okay? See from the mind. Know from the mind. How about breathing is here, very near. This is really far. You still can know from the mind, see from the mind, watch from the mind. Breathing is really near. But you don't know. This is feeling. Knowing must free from, not involved in the feeling. Knowing must be back home. Feeling is here. Breathing in, breathing out. Knowing in the mind. Can you? Knowing the mind. Breathing in, you know in the mind. Breathing out, you know in the mind. When you know in the mind, observe. Mindfulness, how to observe. Knowing and observe. You observe from the mind, can you? Breathing in, how soft, how deep. Can you observe in the mind, from the mind, in the mind? Yeah. If you got your mind, mindfulness, what is mindfulness? Observe, watch and observe. Then you got seeing, okay? Knowing not enough. You must got knowing and seeing. Everybody know. You know how you sit, you know. But you need to develop knowing and seeing. Knowing, you know you have not a good mood, you know. But you still be angry, okay? But if you know you have a good, not good mood, and you see not good mood, then you can overcome your anger. Okay? You know you desire. You know you desire. Yeah, I know. I eat with desire. Knowing not enough. You cannot overcome desire. But you need both knowing, seeing your desire. Knowing and seeing. Knowing is awareness. Seeing is mindfulness, okay? You need knowing, seeing, mindfulness, and awareness. Awareness, knowing, mindfulness, seeing, okay? Knowing, seeing, okay? It depends on if in the vipassana we knowing, seeing deep in the mental quality. But I told you this afternoon, not safe. Because you will fall asleep. If you know deep, I just tell you knowing just your movement, your breathing, or even the rising falling here, rising falling, abdomen, rising falling. This is feeling, okay? And can you know in your mind? Now rising, Now, foreign, can you know in your mind? Yeah, we say knowing from the knower, whatever you know from the knower. And can you see from your mind? When you know from your mind wake up. If you know not from your mind, okay, you cannot see. For example, if I just look, now my mind go out. I try to look. I cannot see because I look very close. But if I just watch, my mind come back. Then I can see, I can know, and I can realize, I can understand this is play, pause, stop, and how to do it. Okay? Same. I just let you be mindful and aware. You need a space between object and the knower. Okay? You need space, a gap. Okay? A gap between object and the knower. I can see who got the knower. I can see how. When you don't have a gap, then first you sit this way. After that, you go this way. This way. Or you go this way in beginning. After that, you go this way. Okay? That means you lost from the starting. Okay? Because if you stay at the knower, you stay this uprising. When you stay with the object, too much concentration, poor awareness, the head go down a bit. That mean, okay? When the head go down, your mind, I can show you something. Your physical body important. If your physical body, okay, your head go down, what happened? Your mind come forward. You know those who have a lot of thought, thinking too much. Those who thinking too much, head not wake up. Always go down. What to do? I don't know. Why? Nah, it's not uprising. Okay? So if you practice meditation, your head go down. You will have a lot of doubt. You understand? So that's why the Buddha says, sit and uprising, okay? You can try now. I can just let you train you to see where your mind. Now, your head up. Your mind calm and empty. Your head down a bit. Your mind go forward. And then you feel heavy, okay? Your head up, your mind go between, okay? And how about your eye? Your eye, bruh, your head up, but your eye, bruh. Your mind, the knower become drunk. Oh, bruh, okay? Or your eyes sad. Your mind no power, okay? Your eye wake up, even you have problem, you not tell people what your problem, your eye still good, your mind wake up, then suffering gone. But now what happened? You have only a big problem, you talk to everybody, my wife, my husband, my family, you talk until you practice meditation, but you spoil your mind, okay? So, how to have good meditation? How? Problem, your problem. Don't have to tell people. My problem, I solve myself. Okay? You have a big problem. Tell people. Tell everybody. But now, if you strengthen your mind, okay, problem come, mindful and aware. Problem gone. Okay? Suffering come, mindful. How to be mindful? Mindful and aware, not this way. Mindful and aware must wake up. Okay? Mindful and aware of your body. Your body will show how your mind is. Okay? So now you know how to to help your children. If your children stay at home, not wake up, okay? And lost, I lost. You know, now your children got some problem, got thought, got suffering. You see, but you need to hug. When you hug, you keep warm. Your children become awareness. Then your children free, wake up and free from all suffering. Okay? Your children don't know how to practice mindfulness and awareness, but you just hug. Your children got awareness, mindfulness, and feel warm, okay, from you. Then your children free from suffering. So now, if you got problem, who else will hug you? No, I don't think so. Can you hug yourself? Hug your heart. Smile. Can you smile to your heart? Now you have problem in heart. How to solve problem by yourself? Smile. You feel warm or not? Smile to your heart. Smile to yourself. You feel more relaxed or not? Because when you smile, you turn your thought to feeling. Now smile. Smile and lost in thought? No, when you smile, you're not lost in thought. Can you smile and thinking too much? Smile and think too much together, can you? Cannot. Cannot smile and think too much. Cannot. Because I told you already, my working into two functions. That's why the Buddha said, the natural way of enlightenment, that is bliss and joy in your heart. And how to develop bliss and joy in your heart? Smile. And more bliss and joy in your heart. Smile with loving kindness. Now smile. Smile. Can you see your heart calm? And what different? What different? Smile and with loving kindness. You see something wake up? Intuition. Smile and more loving kindness. You free all clinging attachment. Intuitive awareness wake up. Okay? Can you see? Not by eye, by your wisdom. Okay? This we call in the Buddhist philosophy, wisdom eye. Now I will teach you how to develop wisdom eye. Now sad. Can you see your sadness? Sad, sad. Can you see? Not by eye, by your wisdom. So when you sad, mindfulness and wisdom see how are you. With mindfulness and wisdom, then the suffering, sadness gone gradually. Okay? But sad, sad or suffering, you can see. Okay? Broken heart, can you see broken heart? Can you see? Yeah, you can see. But why not see before you break broken heart? Why? Okay? Seeing before you got suffering, broken heart, seeing before. How seeing before? Smile. Can you see your smile? If you can see your smile, you not lost. You have the power of intuition. Okay? Intuitive awareness. First, I tell you, see your mind. Your mind becomes still and quiet still. Okay? But now, I tell you, mindful, when you know and see your mind come back. Your mind come back. Just immediately wake up. Quickly. Quickly with loving kindness. Okay? More your mind calm, you can wake up easily. Okay? So when you got calmness already, calmness and not lazy, calmness and then not sleep, calmness and diligent, calmness and do good thing, calmness and more active. Can you? That is your heart. Okay? That is your heart. Then you will got your spiritual wake up. Oh, who is this person? Not handsome, not beautiful now. Who is this person? Do that, do this, do that. Now your awareness will wake up your spirit and soul. Okay? But before your spirit and soul wake up, you must calm down the monkey mind first. Okay? Now you have your body. This is your body friend sleeping inside. Body friend. You know body? In Thai, we use body, your good friend, sleeping, calm your mind, still your mind, and smiling. Spirit and soul wake up, you feel more conscious. Okay? And your spirit and soul wake up, it become sensing. You are feeling wake up, you become more conscious or not? Conscious over the whole body, then you got awareness, seeing, awareness and see, sensing. How much you sense yourself in a day? Never, because you don't know, you have to be mindful and wake up with awareness. And who wake up? Consciousness. That is, we call pure mind. Pure mind is consciousness. Can you see pure mind? Okay? But we bring the monkey mind back home first. Okay? After that, we smile and relax and loving kindness. Then your heart or your heart inside in your subconscious, your consciousness sleeping in subconscious. When you smile and loving kindness, your consciousness come up. This is what we practice to this goal. Or this is how we practice samatha and vipassana to wake up. Okay? So now you know how to wake up. I just tell you, smile and wake up. Loving kindness and wake up. You got sensing, seeing your movement, seeing your sensation, you got or not? Smile and wake up. Because I just tell you the natural way. There are two ways of enlightenment. Okay? Natural way, the Buddha said, bliss and joy. Then you got seeing things as they are. In Thai language, ปราโมทย์ เบิกบานใจทำให้เกิดยัตถาภูตญาณทัศนะ คือเห็นโลกตามความเป็นจริง Now, bliss and joy. Because once today, I not teach you the method, but I just bring you back home. Once you back home, once you wake up, you can cross over. You understand already how to wake up. Before, you just do seriously meditation, but never wake up. I don't know how to wake up. So that's why I teach you, wake up first. Okay, wake up first. Then after you wake up already, you can do any method of meditation because you wake up already. Okay? You can do any method. Today, I not teach you the method. I teach you way of enlightenment. วิธีการหลุดพ้น. Okay? Method, a lot of concept, different, okay? But we just learn the way, okay? Where is your heart good, your mind good? Do good, not do bad, and purify your mind. That is the way. Very simple, okay? That is the way, okay? So now, okay, smile. And loving kindness. And how about can you develop more wholesome feeling in your heart? Okay? smile, loving kindness, and more wholesome feeling, great compassion. Can you just make your feeling good? Can you? Some people say, how to smile, how to loving kindness, how to wake up with loving kindness? That I make it or not? How about why you make your heart sad all the time? You make it or not? You make it, okay? You sad, you make it or not? You make your heart sad. Why I teach you make your heart happy? Why you don't try, but you always make your heart suffer? Okay? Because the Buddha said, do good, not do bad, and do purify your mind. Okay, there is one great master in the forest tradition. He just kept talk from the great master. Okay, just purify your mind. Can you make your mind smile, happy, and brilliant? Can you make it? One day, he teaching this to those who stay in the hospital, sad and fear and afraid. How you wake them up in that situation? If you are cancer, rising, falling, I know, breathing in, breathing out, I know. No, they cannot know because they are so suffer. Okay, but just tell them. Why you make your heart sad? You can make your heart sad. Then you can make your heart happy. Can you make your heart happy? Immediately, they wake up. No fear, okay? In the hospital. Why you always make your heart sad? Make your heart happy. Make your heart wholesome. Whatever good feeling, make it. Can you make it? Okay? Make it. Somebody say, Nivarana, non-self. If I make it, then I got self. Oh, thinking too much. Somebody say, if I make it, thinking too much. And why you make it today? You make it every day, every moment, sad and suffer. That's right? Oh, that's right. Not only make sad and suffer, make yourself angry, make yourself disturbed. You make it or not? So, how to develop more goodness in your heart and how to be away from unwholesome. How to be away from bad or unwholesome. Just make good feeling. Then you away from unwholesome, from bad feeling. So now, I always make my heart enjoy, bliss and joy. Then I can maintain my meditation. The whole day, calmness the whole days, okay? Seeing with wisdom the whole day. Because when your heart bliss and joy, the Buddha say, this is will bring you seeing things as they are, okay? Somebody practice meditation, okay? Okay, good. But in daily life, they make themselves sad. They make themselves angry. How you develop meditation, okay? So now, you want natural way or academic way? I think start with natural way first. If you cannot smile, then you cannot even practice according to academic way, okay? Okay? If you can smile, you can develop calmness, vipassana, and wake up in the calmness easily, okay? So now, I tell you smile already, okay? So you now this afternoon are no sleepy because I know this afternoon must wake up your heart. Smile, 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 okay? But sometimes you smile and you lazy. You not watch yourself. Smile and diligent, mindful watch yourself. Watch your body sitting posture, watch your breathing, watch your stomach movement rising, falling. Can you? Okay? You got awareness and bliss and joy smile, and you got diligent, mindful, watch and observe yourself more and more, more often. And today, I just want you to know, when you wake up, your mind here become more awareness. Now your mind still but not aware because your heart not good. Okay? If your heart good, your mind still and calm and awareness more and more. Okay? So people try to be mindful, aware. Mindful, you can try to be mindful, but awareness is intuition, okay? It's intuitive awareness. You just smile, it come up. If you try seriously, it not come up, okay? Intuitive, okay? Awareness, okay? So now, just bliss and joy in your heart. And then, when you watch your breathing, you can feel your breathing together. Or you watch your stomach rising with bliss and joy in your heart. Okay? Bliss and joy and smile and loving kindness. When you watch, you got seeing from your awareness together. Watch and see and watch. Watch and see and watch. Okay? Then you can see more deeply. You watch and see the breathing. But you got seeing. When I watch this person, maybe I not see the other person. But if I wake up, I see this person, I see everybody. Seeing is wisdom. When you got wisdom, wake up, you seeing everything. Okay? So now, bliss and joy in your heart. Then you got seeing wake up. When you watch your breathing, you see everything. See the breathing and you are feeling good or bad. Okay? It becomes good feeling more and more. Okay? And when you watch your breathing in, seeing your feeling, that is seeing your mind. Now you got vipassana. It depends on if you don't know this concept, you don't know, you just focus the breathing. Focus the rising, falling, and where, or how you see, how the breathing is, how the rising, falling is, and how you see, and how about your feeling. You don't know because you only focus the breathing, or focus the rising, falling. You don't know, oh, I have to see my feeling. Yeah, you have to see your thought and feeling. You see, when you watch, okay, you watch one object. But when you see, you must be able to see your body and mind or body and feeling. When I watch one object, I got one poisonous, the power of mind. When I got one poisonous of mind, and I got seeing, I can see body and mind, okay? I can see not only body and mind, I can see dependent origination. That means body, breath body, soft, subtle, my mind, my heart feel relaxed and really light. My mind, my heart relax, really light. My breathing becomes soft, more softer. Okay? I can see how the breathing affect on your mind, affect on my mind. My mind affect on the breathing. Okay? So if you can see relationship between body and mind. Now you can see now what I got in my heart. You got seeing. You can see deeply. If you only watch, okay, and poor seeing, poor awareness, you only got calmness meditation. Anyhow, I will bring you to samatha again first. Watch and see first the body, can you? Okay? But in daily life, what you watch? What you see, you need to watch and see in daily life. You not sit only. You have to work. You have to talk. You have to think. So in daily life, just watch and see. Even you are so busy, but you got only three things to do in daily life. Speaking, doing, thinking. So first, I just brush up your mindfulness. Let you brush up your mindfulness by yourself. Okay? In daily life, you tell me no time, practice meditation, but you have time to speak or not? Watch and you see your speaking. You have time to do a job or not? Watch and see your doing. You have time to think or not? Yeah. Then practice, watch and see your thinking. Can you? So this, if you practice both the formal practice, closing eye, but how long you can practice closing eye in a day? Maybe 15 minutes, half an hour maximum, okay? And then you lost 20 hours? No. So there, you not lost. You know how to practice in daily life. Daily life, even you so busy, you feel disturbed, you just rely. You got only three things to do, even you are very busy. Speaking, watch and see. You are speaking, how you are speaking, and how feeling when you speak. When you speak good, how you are feeling. When you speak bad, how you are feeling. Okay? This is vipassana in daily life. Okay? Watch and see you are doing. You are doing rush. How you are feeling. Can you watch and see your feeling? You are doing mindfully. Watch and see how you're feeling, how you're doing, okay? And watch and see now, just thinking about whatever. Can you see your thought? Okay? But don't try to stop or force your thought, your mind not thinking, okay? You become crazy if you force your mind not thinking. I'm now crazy now. Okay. Just when you got thought, you just see your thought and watch together. First, I just advise you awareness and see first. You got bad feeling, awareness and see. Then watch together. You got happiness, awareness and see. Watch together. Okay? You got disturbance in your mind, a lot of thought. Awareness first. Awareness and see. And watch together. Because you are always focused very good. When I tell you watch, you focus too much. When I tell you watch, you not watch. You more than watching, you focus. So people, they always focus too much. Okay? Watch your thought. Focus, focus. Then I can see your eye when you focus. Okay? I can see your attention. You focus. The Buddha say, okay? Knowing, seeing. Okay? Okay? Mindful and aware. Mindful. Can you mindful watch and observe yourself? If you focus yourself, this is your self. You got self in the beginning. Your selfness, but just watch from your mindfulness. How to watch from your mindfulness? Awareness first. Awareness and see how you're doing. Then just explore, watch and observe. Okay? Awareness first. Awareness first. Okay? If you're not awareness first, then you know what to watch. You don't know what to watch. Your awareness first, now anger arising, awareness first, then watch and observe, okay? Then you can free your mind, your heart from anger or other disturbance, okay? So now, watch and observe your body, then watch and observe your sensation that cool or hot or whatever sensation on the body. People don't know, they focus sensation. You must knowing first. Okay? Then you know what to watch. Awareness first. Awareness and see. Awareness and see. Awareness and see how your body feeling with whatever sensation, awareness and see, whatever and see, awareness and see, awareness and see, until you got more conscious. How to develop awareness and see? How? Relax. Then you feel more conscious. And then you got awareness and see. Relax. If you have self, try to watch the sensation. You cannot see clearly because you, this is the object, but you seriously, you watch the object. You cannot see. Desire bring you go forward. Okay? But this one come nearly attack you. Thought, emotion, awareness and see. Then it go a bit farther, further. Awareness and see, it go farther, further. Then you can watch and observe what am observe. This thing, when you're not involved, it's arising, disappear. This thing you involve, it become attached. You're not involved, you awareness and see. Then you can see it, the arising disappear. So thing impermanent. But if you attach, it become permanent and you're suffering. Then you can see impermanent. And then you can see why you're suffering. Because you're not awareness and see, you don't know. Okay? When you don't know, you cannot accept. When you not accept, you cannot understand. When you cannot understand, you cannot let go. That's right. So, today I just tell you, look, watch and see with mindfulness, but not enough. You must relax and smile. Please enjoy. You got awareness and see from your heart. Okay? Anyhow, now you wake up already. But now, I would like you to awareness and see. First, your body, you can awareness and see and watch and observe how you sit, how you move already. Awareness and see your sensation. Okay? Cool or hot, warm. Awareness and see already. Then, watch and observe. When you watch and observe, then you got really good calmness. And accept understanding, okay? And letting go. And now, awareness and see your thought. People don't know, they watch thought. Oh, they watch thought. Oh, thought, they watch. It looks something strange, their eyes. Oh, terrible, okay? Awareness and see thought coming, watch and observe. Awareness and see you think bad, watch and observe. Awareness and see you think good, watch and observe. Okay? And how about when you chanting, namo tassa bhagavato, you know namo tassa, or om mani padme hum, what you chanting? Now, you awareness first, you chanting, namo, okay, two words. Or Buddha. In Thailand, there is Buddha meditation. But Buddha, they not see the mind. Only Buddha by mouth. Buddha, or by thinking. And they not see the mind who wake up with awareness and see. So today I just tell you what I got from my experience. I got this from my teaching in Singapore. One day I teaching a lot of different approach in meditation. I got intuition wake up. I just namo. And my mind see two words. You know the meaning namo? Namo tassa, bow to the Buddha. Namo, bow. Okay? Your heart bow to the Buddha. Namo, not nom. Namo, bow to the Buddha. Dhamma, sangha, namo tassa. One day in Singapore, I teaching meditation. My mind wake up. Namo. Namo. And I can see Namo. And I can see the mind itself, not more. You know, I tell you, your cushion is the object. Your mind knowing is the knower. This is far. This is really far. But here, you are breathing. Breathing in, this is object. You know from the mind inside. Okay? So this is now near. Okay? Because this is the body contact. But if you want to train to see your thought, you just chanting whatever. For example, namo. Two words, easy. Na is short. Mo is long. Different rhythm, namo. Different pronunciation, namo. Can you see pronunciation? Namo, 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 namo. Because when you see rhythm, namo, 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 you can go back to your mind in 5 seconds. Oh, wake up really fast. Can you see chanting in your mind? Before you chanting whatever, you only chanting and you chanting with thought. Today you chanting, but go into your mind, whatever. Two words, namo, namo, namo. Can you see na, very short rhythm, mo, long rhythm, okay? Namo, namo. Can you see? Not see here. You chant from the mind, the knower. Okay. Think about your family. Can you see your mind think about family? Think about whatever you like. Can you see your mind think about whatever you like? But now thinking about two words. Na. Can you see your mind think about na? Mo. Na. Mo. This I will train you to be able to see your mind thinking. But before you think too much, you can not follow your mind. But now I just train your mind two words. Can you see different? Namo, 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 namo. Can you see? Na. When you see na, you see mo. Namo, namo. Who see namo? Who? There is the one inside, seeing namo, very close, okay? Then you can see namo, namo. You can see the way up mind really fast, okay? Namo, 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 namo. So that's why now in Thailand, before, I don't know, I just do chanting meditation. Buddha, 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 and fall asleep. Now I never fall asleep. Buddha, 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 Buddha. When I say Buddha in my mind, Buddha is short, Do is long. Buddha, 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 Buddha. My mind see Buddha, my mind see Buddha, my mind can see my mind. My mind see Buddha, my mind can see my mind. More seeing Buddha, more seeing the mind, more seeing Buddha, mind. What happened? Short rhythm and long rhythm. Short pronunciation, long pronunciation. What effect on your mind? When you see short rhythm, Buddha close up, Do open, your mind become like this. Buddha, Buddha. Buddha, namo, namo. Because you know, deep into your mind, there are level. Go to the bottom of mind. Okay? If you just see namo, each level, there is connection. Okay? If you can see na, it become connect. More is become open the door. Na mo, na mo, na mo. My mind become expanding. as big as sky in 1 minute. Namo. Not my mouth, my mind. I just pronounce, you just pronounce inside. Okay? Na. Can you see? Mo. Na. Mo. Na. Mo. Na. Mo. Na. Mo. And you see what the result in your mind. Na. Your mind become one pointed. Mo. Your mind become open. Na. Mo. Na. Mo. Na. Mo. Na. Mo. 1 minute. You go. Wake up inside. Pureness, emptiness, okay? Can you realize that? Okay, we have a break, and then we will do it again, because now I just give you some idea, okay? Some guidance. Now break for 10 minutes, okay? Good? So, break, and then no thoughts, then you wake up. Okay. Namo, namo. You just namo, 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 namo. Okay. Buddho, 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 Buddho. Cross up, open. Cross up, open. You feel like that? Yeah. Yeah. We are traveling inside into the nature of mind. Namo, namo, namo.
Difficult.
Huh? Difficult. But we start thing difficult. Then. Other thing more easy. Yeah. Okay?
That's perfect.
Okay. So today I will teach you all methods in Thailand. All methods in Thailand. Okay? Ah, more hot water.
Okay.